tere, tka, tere, tere, ka, tere, tka, tere, tka, 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 tere, tka, tere, tere, ka, tere, tka, tere, tere, ka, tere, tere, ka.
So this basic groove called alpha is the heart of the piece. Before I teach it to you, I want to talk about bocce choice. So there's a lot of hitting the rims, and so this piece will tear up your softwood bocce. I don't know if you can see that. If you would still like to play with hole, one thing that you can do to extend the life of your bocce is, if you can see, there's a change in the shade of the wood here. So this is the super glue Duro brand. So what I do is carefully coat like a thin line at a time, rotating and letting it dry, and then taking sandpaper and sanding it down so that it's just completely smooth. I got this tip and the idea to use this exact brand, Duro brand, from Asano Taiko US and Yuta Kato. They do this to their Odaiko Bachi because what it does is it holds the fibers together a little better. In terms of sound, let's try out a few different types of bachi to see what they sound like. If you have a lot of options, you should think about what chudaiko you're playing with and how they sound and put it together into kind of a coherent whole. Do you want it to sound like raw and gravelly? Do you want it to sound like fun and like kind of tinny and bright? Test it out with this groove first to make sure that you've got like the best equipment of whatever you have to work with, because I don't want to hurt the skin too much. But here's what this sounds like. Ichi, ni, so, re. You get a full bodied sound here compared to some of the other bocce that I'm going to show you. A better option for the life of your bocce would be to go with harder bocce. These are actually quite short maple bocce. Yeah, so when I hit the rim with them, obviously you get a completely different sound out of it, but it doesn't dent the bocce. So let's listen to that real quick. Ichi, ni, so, re. I have two more interesting options for you. Western drumsticks. I think they're made out of a heavier wood. Ichi, ni, so, re. So that was trying to play the kaz with the ball. Let me try playing it with kind of further down. Ichi, ni, so, re. I kind of like that fuller sound better, actually. And then one final option is bamboo or takebachi. Ichi, ni, so, re. Usually when you're hitting the skin, you hit with the flat part. So here's a flat part. You can hit it with the side, right? Like this. For the rim, I really think it's better to hit it from the side. The flat, the sides, feels like I could get a much better hit out of the sides. So the technique here then is going to be to hit these tere flat, and to hit the kaz, you're gonna have to twist your hand a little bit for that. So ichi, ni, so, re. Consider the equipment you're playing on. So right now I'm just gonna teach this on a sumo daiko, so it has a nice smooth wooden rim. So I don't need to worry about running into bolts or hitting a rope or something. As for sticking, I don't have strong opinions. Whatever works and sounds good. There's a lot of just fast little stuff, so whatever gets your hands in the right places at the right time. I refer to this whole groove as alpha. There's a particular set of alpha variations that are played in a particular order, but I want y'all to get a sense of the groove itself first. Compared to the lines of the chudaiko part, the alpha groove is actually two lines long. I actually refer to each line as alpha zero and then alpha something else. Sometimes just alpha zero, alpha zero. Alpha zero is kind of the basic basic groove here. So it goes ichi, ni, so, re, tere, taka, tere, tere, ka. So that is one alpha zero. For sticking, lately here's how I've been doing it, slowing it down. Ichi, ni, so, re, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, hop, ichi, ni, so, re, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, and the higher pitch ones are the kas. Ichi ni so re right right left right right left right. A few things are important technique wise. Keep these teres even, the right and the left hand. We don't want where the right is much heavier, and don't squish them together. And then the second thing is the kas. Of course, trying to hit within the top inch for the brightest sound. Here's how to get the max volume. If this is the part of the rim that I'm trying to hit and I hit like this, see how it slides off? It's much better to be hitting perpendicular to it so that it doesn't have anywhere to go. Secondly, wrist snap. So at the final moment here, I'm not just hitting like this, see, keeping my wrist straight, I mean, like that so you can see. I'm really bringing in, like letting that energy roll through my hand. It makes such a huge difference. Listen. Versus. I'm just getting a lot more force out that way. So, and it's less wear and tear on my wrists actually to play fluidly like that. On a shimidaiko, the ropes will get in the way, the bolts get in the way and tear up your bachi. It's really annoying. So you're gonna have to start really focusing on the ka, like knowing exactly, okay, where am I going to hit? So if I look at my shimidaiko, there's like little variations in color and things like that, right? So I actually pick a point and like I pick a little feature, natural skin coloration feature. On a shimidaiko, you could pick a pair of ropes that you're gonna aim to go between, or a pair of bolts that you're aiming to go between. That's the one that you're going between. Whenever you approach the shime, figure out where the spots that you're gonna hit the kas on each side are. Focus on hitting those and not hitting anything else on the sides. If you practice the position specificity of where you hit, it will get better. It will, I promise. I'm inside, it's the pandemic, so I can't play this full out. You really need to play this full out. You'll be practicing and you think that, okay, you've got it right, it sounds good, and then you get to a performance and I can't tell you how many times it's happened that I'm just like, oh my gosh, shime, play louder. The shime part needs to be played quite loud. It, you know, it really takes center stage. Sorry to go on and on about it, but it's really important. If you need to practice quietly at home, it's still valuable, but please set aside time to practice playing like, did it, the ka, did it. Especially because getting those bigger motions and actually having the precision of where you hit, it's a lot easier to hit where you wanted to hit when you're only going did it. Please do spend some time, you know, all the way from the top, or at least getting a full elbow bend. I gave you a version of the kuchishoka that doesn't do much to tell you about timing, but it can actually be really helpful to have kiai in there to help you keep time and to help stay together with other people. There's a couple different versions of this. Some is just having like certain landmarks like doro si the ka ha doro si doro ka ei doro the ka doro doro ka, right? So then I'm doing things like marking some of the, you know, the downbeats and some of the major offbeats. So sorry, sometimes I say doro instead of tere. You can also put in all of the subdivisions. So if we say it really slowly, it would be
ichi ni so re.
So that's a lot of subdivisions, but part of the point of that is to convince you that the tere really do have specific places that they go. It's not just like try to hit the second hit as close to the first hit as you can. Some pieces are like that. This is not like that. So the simplest thing you can do with alpha zero is you can play pairs of them, alpha zero, alpha zero. So if I have a four line phrase, I want to play four pairs, so that's eight alpha zeros. So let's try 100. So it'll go so re tere te ka tere tere ka. So let's do eight of them. Ichi ni so re. I've been playing this at 120 BPM, so here's what that sounds like. We'll do eight alpha zeros. Ichi ni so re. The next thing you need to know are the alpha variations. So there's different endings. Instead of the sol, re, te, re, ka, you can do all sorts of things. You can do whatever you want. And fundamentally, this piece was written intending, you know, for there to be shime players taking these ideas and really building off them with different variations of their own. But there are four variations that are featured in the piece. They are called alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, alpha 4. The first half of an alpha line, we call it alpha 0, right? And so if we play plain alpha, that's an alpha 0, alpha 0, like what we just did when we played 8 alphas. So that's 4 lines of alpha 0, alpha 0. But when these alpha variations come up, what happens is you play alpha 0, alpha 1, or alpha 0, alpha 2, alpha 0, alpha 3, alpha 0, alpha 4, like that. We're going to start with alpha 2 because it's the most similar to alpha 0. So if alpha 0 is like this, sol, re, te, re, te, ka, te, re, te, re, ka, that little bit at the end, sol, re, te, re, ka, it's going to turn into sol, re, te, re, ka, te, re, te, re, ka. So here's what alpha 2 sounds like. Te, re, te, ka, te, re, te, re, ka, te, re, te, re, ka. Now putting that together with an alpha 0 to have that full line that ends in alpha 2, so alpha 0, alpha 2, that sounds like this. Ich, ni, so, re, te, re, te, ka, te, re, te, re, ka, te, re, te, ka, te, re. There are two sections of the piece where alpha 2 is played like that, as alpha 0, alpha 2, alpha 0, alpha 2. Let's sing that Kuchishoga with the metronome. I'm back at 100 BPM. So alpha 0, alpha 2, alpha 0, alpha 2. Ich, ni, so, re, te, re, te, ka, te, re, te, re, ka, hup, te, re, te, ka, te, re. Let's play that. We're gonna go alpha 0, alpha 2, alpha 0, alpha 2. Ich, ni, so, re. The next variation to learn is alpha 4. There is a reason that I'm teaching them in this order. Alpha 4 goes ich, ni, so, re, te, re, te, ka, te, re, ten, ken, ten, ken. So this little bit at the end, the so, re, ten, ken, ten, ken, is actually a really common motif. It ends a lot of the verses of the song, and it also ends the piece. Those are the last hits. So on Chudaiko, that sounds like so, re, ton, con, ton, con. I play those as so, re, right, left, right, left. But I do think other things are possible. If you want to be really sure to nail the timing, you can use the pineapple, pineapple, shake it trick. You just play the pine and the shake. So you go pineapple, pineapple, shake it, pineapple, pineapple, shake it, pineapple, 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 shake it, shake it. The way that this alpha 4 is gonna sound would be like sore, shake it, pineapple, pineapple, shake it. So let's take a look at that. Sore, shake it, pineapple, pineapple, shake it. So if I speed it up to match the metronome, it'll sound like this. Sore, shake it, pineapple, pineapple, shake it. Remember, I only hit the pine and the shake. So here we go. So re, shake it, pineapple, pineapple, shake it. So let's sing alpha 4. Ich, ni, so re, te re, te ka, te re. Shake it, pineapple, pineapple, shake it. Or you can do the normal Kuchishoga. Ich, ni, so re, te re, te ka, te re. Ten, 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 ten. So to make the full line, we add alpha 0 onto that. So we have alpha 0, alpha 4. Ich, ni, so, re, te, re, te, ka, te, re, te, re, ka, te, re, te, ka, te, re, ten, ken, ten, ken. Or with the pineapple version, we have ich, ni, so, re, te, re, te, ka, te, re, te, re, ka, te, re, te, ka, te, re. Shake it, pineapple, pineapple, shake it. Let's play alpha 0, alpha 4. Ichi, ni, sore. So beyond alpha 0, you now know alpha 2 and alpha 4. This is enough to play the GUG for an entire verse of the song. We're gonna have three pairs of lines. The first pair will end in alpha 2, the second one will also end in alpha 2, and the last one will end in alpha 4. You're gonna play alpha 0, alpha 2, alpha 0, alpha 2, alpha 0, alpha 4. This is played along with a section called abacus. So we're gonna go alpha 0, alpha 2, alpha 0, alpha 2, alpha 0, alpha 4. Ichi, ni, so, re. The next line to learn is alpha 1. Its bit at the end starts a little bit later than the others. So, re. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, do, ka, do, ka, do, ka. So if you notice, I said 1, 2, 3, do, ka, do, ka, do, ka. All the other little alphabets, they would have started at 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. And after the 2, they would have started. So they would have started on the 3, but this one is going to start on that last little bit, the 4. Ichi, ni, so, re, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, do, ka, do, ka, do, ka. So all of alpha 1 sounds like so, re, te, re, te, ka, te, re, te, ka, te, ka, te, ka. So, re, te, re, te, ka, te, re, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, te, ka, te, ka, te, ka. Now putting that together with its alpha 0, so alpha 0, alpha 1, the full line sounds like this. So, re, te, re, te, ka, sticking. So, right, left, right, left, right, left. For some reason, I've been playing it the opposite way. So, left, right, left, right, left, right. And the reason that's harder is because I have to end with the right and then immediately go into a tere. So, I'm going to recommend ichi, ni, so, re. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. I think it's a lot easier because then you've hit a left before the tere of the next line. Let's play it with that sticking. We're just going to play alpha 0, alpha 1. Ichi, ni, so, re. The last piece to learn is alpha 3. So going back to alpha 0, the little bit at the end is so, re, te, re, ka. So you're playing that ka with your right hand. Instead, the first thing that's going to happen in the alpha 3 bit is you're going to play te, re, ten. So that right hand is going to be playing on the skin and the left hand is going to prepare to play kas. The way that alpha 3 sounds is so, re, te, re, ten, z, ka, ka, ten. So that's going to be played so, re, right, left, right, left, left, right. So the kuchishoka for alpha 3. So, re, te, re, te, ka, te, re, te, re, ten, z, ka, ka, ten. And then again, the sticking for that is ichi, ni, so, re, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, a left, left, right. So let's play alpha 0, alpha 3. Ichi, ni, so, re. So now you know alpha 1 through 4. There is something called full alpha, which is these four in order, the 1, 2, 3, 4 order. So, but you always play each line with the alpha 0. You never play any of the alphabets by themselves. So you're going to play alpha 0, alpha 1, alpha 0, alpha 2, alpha 0, alpha 3, alpha 0, alpha 4. Please pause the video right now and try to remember what each of those are. I know it may be hard because it's been a few minutes since we've talked about those, but trust me, everything we understand about human memory research says that if you stop and suffer through trying to remember that right now, that it'll actually help you. So please pause. Okay, welcome back. Good job trying to figure it out. Alpha 1 ended in sore, do ka, do ka, do ka. Alpha 2 is the one that we started with. That's the one that's most similar, right, to alpha 0. So alpha 2 ends in sore, do ro ka, do ro do ro ka. And I'm using the Chu Daiko Kuchi Shoga again, sorry. So in Shime Daiko Kuchi Shoga, that would be sore, tere ka, tere tere ka. Alpha 3 was the last one we learned. It was the one where we do the ka's on our left hand. So that's sore, tere ten, ka, ka ten. And then the fourth one is the one where there's no ka's, then the pineapples, right? So that one is sore, ten, ken, ten, ken. So please pause the video right now and take a moment to, now having gone over each of them, try to stitch it together yourself. Try to just stop and sing alpha 0, alpha 1, alpha 0, alpha 2, alpha 0, alpha 3, alpha 0, alpha 4. Go ahead. Hi, welcome back. Thank you again for trying to stitch it all together yourself. I know it's tricky. Here's the answers. All four lines of full alpha. Ich, ni, so, re, tere. Teka, tere. Tereka, tere. Teka, tere. Teka, 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 tere. Teka, tere. Tereka, tere. Teka, tere. Tereka, tere, tereka, tere. Teka, tere. Tereka, tere. Teka, tere. Tere ten, ska, ka ten, tere. Teka, tere. Tereka, tere. Teka, tere. Ten, ken, ten, ken. Full alpha, the variations 1 through 4 in order. We're practicing this at 100 BPM. You want to work up to at least 120. Remember, I'm indoors and I'm trying to play quietly. And also I have the convenience of no ropes or bolts to have to worry about. So when you're practicing this, be more careful about these things and get a good wrist snap. Really come down on that. That it. Ich, ni, so, re. Yay! So now taking a look at the song flow sheet, we can see how much of the piece that, as the shime player, we can already play. So there's an intro section during which you do not play. There's a full alpha during which you play exactly what we just played all by yourself. Then the first instance of the theme, or kind of chorus of the piece, during which we play the simplified alpha, which is alpha 0, alpha 0, 4 times, aka alpha 0, 8 times, which is what we played a long time ago at the very beginning. There are little ending tags that each of the Chu Daiko sections end with, so sometimes you're going to have to do things like drop the last tereka. So just to explain what that sounds like, I'm going to play the last two alpha zeros, so the last line of theme. This is what the G that goes with it would sound like. Ich, ni, so, re, tere, teka, tere, tereka, tere, teka, tere. So you see, I dropped the last tereka. The next is abacus, during which we play the alpha 0, alpha 2, alpha 0, alpha 2, alpha 0, alpha 4. For the second instantiation of theme, we play a full alpha, except on that last alpha 4, we drop the important part. We drop the ten ken, ten ken. It's gonna sound like this. Ich, ni, so, re, tere, teka, tere, tereka, tere, teka, tere. So right after the second theme is a section called layer cake, and layer cake is going to start with the full alpha, no changes. And then after that, you're going to play the same G that you played for abacus, which was that 2-2-4 thing. I think you have an option for the alpha 4 at the end of layer cake. I usually just play the first tere. But I think if you have a lot of two daikos, like actually the rhythms do sound pretty good together, so you can play through the full alpha 4. So either you can ignore everything I'm saying right now and just play that abacus G like exactly the same way you played it for abacus, or you'll see videos of us playing it more recently, you'll see the following. This will go with the last line of layer cake. Ich, ni, so, re, tere. From there on, there's different juchis that are being played. We've now learned the first six things that happen in the song, and you can now play the juchi with each of them. All right, starting with full alpha. Ich, ni, so, re, tere, teka. Optionally, dance, 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 get. Yay!